rebounding. How's he doing it? And with him rebounding, like, does it take less pressure off the picks?
No, because we still had to box everybody out. But nah, it definitely helps to have a guard that's willing to come in and get some rebounds that we can't get sometimes.
So you guys are doing the boxing out, he just sneaks in and grabs him.
That's what I tell him.
There's been a bunch of them that he's picked up off the floor.
He's doing good. It's just a matter of what we're supposed to do. You know what we need to do.
Hugs is a way to call the game. Is it frustrating you guys sometimes?
No, it can. I mean, you're calling every touch foul nowadays, so it's kind of hard to pressure somebody when you can't touch them.
And they're calling every touch foul, they're calling every half walk.
Yeah.
I mean, does it ruin the flow of the game, especially when you're trying to do what you're doing?
It can, but I mean, we're trying to wear people out, but when so many stop in the game, it kind of gives them a break.
I don't jinx or anything, but over the course of almost 4 years now, you haven't missed a game. I'm just wondering, is there a secret behind that? Is that something you think about, or did you know? Or?
No, I don't think about it, but yeah, I knew it. I've only missed a couple games ever.
So there had to be times when you weren't 100% there, right?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
You got to play through a little bit.
You got the big one out of the way in high school, right?
Yeah, that's right. No more of those.
Is there something different in your head, preparation-wise, when you know you're going against the link that they have? I mean, you're going to box out every game, I get that, but is there something different or more concertedness in your head going into that game?
I mean, it's definitely a bigger focus because that's what they do. That's how they score points. They're going to get offensive rebounds and third down the post. So, I mean, it's a different game plan, but same kind of prep.
Are there times where it takes two guys boxing out one against bigger guys like that?
I mean, there's times, but you can't really do that because you'll leave someone open. So everybody's got to take care of their own responsibility.
Coach was saying in interviews after the Kansas game that towards the end of the game he hurt the ankle and couldn't slide or couldn't really push off on it. So I'm just kind of thinking, what goes in, you know, after that game, treatment-wise, and to get yourself ready to play, you know, this game a couple days later?
I just go on the dog and listen to whatever he is. I don't want to really get you right. I mean, it's 3 days, so it's not really that's long enough.
Are you going back to get ready for a game? You play a team that's not seen this press. That's an advantage. You know that, right? I'm sure they know that, too. Does it change anything as far as, I don't know, excitement level, effort, anticipation? I don't know. It always seems like you guys arrive at that other level, you're different. I feel like you would get there sooner than later against someone who's never seen you, right?
I mean, they don't really know how to attack us.
Before he goes up.
That helps a little bit. Gets a nice split second.